Thank you very much for joining us for this FKCCI Ask and Share live session on Korean visa. We received these days a lot of questions about visa. First, just before the election of the mayor of Seoul, some of you wondered who can vote and by extension, how we can get the permanent resident visa as only permanent residents are authorized to participate to a local election. After that, we had a big issue, you know, with the visa suspension for residents in France. We did our best at the FKCCI to advocate this issue and to support you in this very evolutive process of visa issuance. It is why we would like today to share with you some information we had collected. But the most important today is the exchange with you and the information you can also share. So don't hesitate to participate, even during my presentation. If you have any question or if you want to add something, you can just turn on your camera and your microphone anytime. And I prepared to open the discussion some few slides about the general framework, a quick reminder of visa types, visa issuance, in particular for residents in France, and some statistics. Afterwards, we will see a little more in details some visa, in particular resident visa and business visa. It is important to understand which visa we can get in Korea because usually the immigration office just say if you are or not eligible for the visa you request, but do not support you to look for the better solution for you. It is a general observation when we discuss with public authorities, it is always better to know what we can ask before asking and sometimes argue our case based on legal text. And then it is exactly the same for visa. Then we'll begin with an overview of existing visa in Korea. There are on this slide some categories in gray because I will not insist on them as I assume they will not be interesting for us today. For example, A visa for diplomats and public officials from a foreign country or international organization. After, we can make a distinction between short-term visa and long-term visa. In the first category, we have the B1 visa, which is called visa exempted. The authorized activities under this status depends on the bilateral visa waiver agreement. In the case of France, we can engage in all activities provided for the C3 visa, which include tourism, training, education, and even business activities as market research, business communication, consulting, or contract negotiation. Usually, there is no any French people with a C3 visa, as they can come under the B1 status without visa, but it is now a little bit more used. After, among the short-term visas, there is also the B2 visa for tourism and transit, the C1 visa for news reporters, and the C4 visa for short-term employees. With a C3 visa, we can be involved in business activities, but we cannot be employees. Concretely, we cannot receive legally a salary from an entity in Korea. It is why there is the C4 visa, which is authorized for a limited list of activities, such as artistic performance and sport, lecture and speeches, or to bring a technical support or expertise, or to work in the ICT sector. After, among the long-term visa, we have first D-type visa. This D3 and D4 visa are both for trainees, but D3 is only for Korean companies and more precisely for exporting Korean companies. D4 visa is more common. It is available for people learning Korean language at the university, students and researchers in organizations which cannot sponsor a D2 visa, and people who are doing a training in a foreign invested company. Then Korean companies cannot have a trainee under D4 visa. We discussed before on Kakao about the internship allowance. then I remind you that the amount paid for an internship is not regulated by the Labor Standards Act if you have signed a convention with a French university. In this case, the allowance amount should be provided by the convention, and there is no minimum and no social cotization to pay. Of course, internship should have a training purpose and cannot fill a permanent work. I will pass after the visa in blue, as we'll see them in details after. Among E-type visa, the E3 visa for researchers is usually used for research centers, but it can work for a corporate research center. So if you have R&D activity, you may consider this visa, but it is very restrictive. The E4 visa for technician or engineer was set up to allow transfer technology towards Korea. The E5 visa for special professional is very specific, as it applies to doctors, pilots, ship captains, and even a tour guide at Kumgang Mountain in North Korea. The E7 is very common, and we'll see it more closely. The E9 visa aims to bring to Korea a cheap and non-qualified workforce. Then it is not open for French citizens. For F-type visa, we'll come back on resident visa F2 and F5. The F1 visa is mainly for family of overseas Koreans and a household employee for diplomatic mission. F3 visa is for the family of foreigners, F4 for overseas Korean, and F6 for spouse of a Korean citizen. Then today, there are in Korea 4,800 French citizens with one of the visa we just see. Among them, there are 500 short-term visa and 4,300 long-term visa. Since January 2020, we saw, of course, a strong decrease of the number of French people in short-term visa. The number of students and working holiday visa also sharply decreased from 1,500 in January 2020 to 600 in January 2021. But there was a surge in February, and we came back at 1,500 with more students than 1 year before, as the part of a working holiday, which is not delivered anymore, is now very small. But this increase was stopped as visa issuance was suspended by Korea on March 3rd. And after, if we exclude short-term visa and students, we see that there is a core group of the French community, which is very stable and which continue to increase. By type of visa, students in D2 is the most important group in the French community. After, there is a F6 visa for marriage migrants with 600 French people. The F3 visa for families of foreigners and D4 visa for trainees. Business visa arrived after. They were very stable since 1 year. There are the E7 visa with 280 persons, the D8 visa for investor, and the D9 for trade. I will say now a few words about visa issuance policy. On the Korea side, there are a lot of actors in the visa process. During the past few days, we discussed with all of them. There is first the MOFA with the Korean embassy in France, but also the Korean embassy in Germany, because as you know, since March 15th, residents in France and in Germany have to submit their visa application to KVAC, the Korean Visa Application Center, which provides all application-related services. KVAC headquarters is at Berlin, but there is an office at Paris to receive visa applications. Those applications are sent to Berlin, and if there is a difficulty, KVAC Berlin will address them to the embassy at Berlin. Then KVAC is a center operated by the IOM, the International Organization for Migration, on behalf of the Korean government. IOM is an international organization and is a part of the United Nations system. After, for some business visa, we need a validation of the important business purpose of the travel, which is usually delivered by the MOTI. For some other visa, we also need to start the process with the immigration service, which is affiliated to the Ministry of Justice, in particular for visa sponsored by a company in Korea. And there is also the KDCA, who establish the list of a high sanitary risk country, which has an automatic impact on the visa issuance process. With all those actors, we sometimes encounter difficulties to conciliate each position. It is why COTRA and the Ombudsman support us to avoid a blockage. Then, as you know, visa issuance was suspended for all residents in France since March, but there was exception, and since last week, those exceptions were extended. First, we continued to obtain visa for important business purpose through a letter from the MOTI, which is competent to recognize, as we said, the important business purpose. After the change, which happened last week, visa for important business purpose will continue to be issued, but the procedure is quite different, as in some specific cases, we'll not need anymore a letter from the MOTI. But sometimes we need a letter. Then it's different for each visa. And of course, the important change to last week is that a family of those who have a long-term visa in Korea can also receive a visa from KVAC. Family means here spouse and minor children. We'll now do a focus on some visa. And the first, the visa, the long-term resident visa F2. There are today 100 French citizens who have this F2 visa. It should not be confused with the F5 visa for permanent resident. We'll see just after this one. The visa F2 is open in many cases. For foreign children of Korean nationals, for the family of a F5 visa holder, the family of a permanent resident, also for refugees. It is also open for investors. It can be an investor who invested $500,000 and spent 3 years under the D8 visa for investors. It can be an executive of a foreign invested company, which invests the same amount and who spent 3 years in Korea. It can also be an investor who invested $300,000 and has at least two Korean employees without any condition on the period in Korea. If you are in one of those cases, you don't need further conditions. In particular, you don't need to get any points. The F2 visa can be obtained by someone who had the F5 visa before and want to stay in Korea for social human rights. If you invoke this reason, you will need the agreement of the Ministry of Justice. It is the same for the case F. If you had been in Korea for 5 years, you can argue that your life is in Korea and get the agreement of the Ministry of Justice. I will pass the case J for E9, E10, and H2 visas because there are no French citizens with those visas. You can also apply for F2 visa if you work for a public institution in Korea. The following case, the visa F27, is important. Then I will come back on this case just after. Last two cases are for investors, mainly in real assets, according to a list established by the Ministry of Justice, and for the family of a F2 visa holder. This visa, the F2 visa, can be interesting for you if you stay in Korea for a long time. It can be delivered for 5 years, and it is usually a first step before to get the permanent visa F5. It is also interesting for from a professional point of view, as you can work with the F2 without the sponsorship of a company. As you know, for some companies, there are some constraints and sometimes some difficulties to hire foreigners, but they have no those problems to hire a F2 visa. But it is important for the F2 visa, business activities can be limited. For cases D, F, and J, you are limited to your professional sector. But for most of them, most of the cases, you can work without any limitation. In particular, I would like to insist on two cases. First, the case K. We often hear that the spouse of expatriate cannot work. It is not exact if he or she can get a F2 visa. Secondly, for F27 visa, there was a lot of comment these days. We said that it doesn't allow anymore to own its business or to work as a freelancer. It is not completely exact. You can do what you want with the F27 visa, but you have to get enough points to get it. And from last December, the Immigration Service will not take into account your activity as a business owner or a freelancer to give you additional points. You have to get your points without your professional activity. And if you want a visa based on your business activity, you have to choose the investor visa. I will explain now how we can get a F27 visa. First, there are some conditions as a period in Korea, usually 3 years, except if your annual income is above 40 million won, or if you are recognized as a foreign talent. But you can also apply if you work for a company listed on a KOSPI or KOSDAQ, then a big Korean company. And you can apply if you are the spouse of someone who gets the F27 visa. But in all those cases, you will need to get 80 points from different criteria as your age, your academic curriculum, your level in Korean and your integration, and your annual income. There are these days two kinds of issues for F27 visa holders. First, the first issue, you can lose it. If you don't meet anymore the condition to get 80 points, you cannot renew your visa. For example, someone who gets points thanks to its age may receive less points when he will have to renew his visa, as it might be a little bit older. And after, there was a controversy about the annual income. If you earn more than 100 million won, you will get 60 points, but you need a justification. And for example, a labor contract. And it is this point which can be difficult for a business owner. If it is your main activity and then your main source of revenue, you might be under the minimum and the visa will be rejected. Then in practical, it can lead to difficult situation. In particular, if you are at the beginning of your business, as a visa F27 is not dedicated to those who want to start their business. I will continue with visa F5 for permanent resident. There are several ways to get a F5 visa. First, we have a visa. If you have a visa between D7 and E7 or F2 visa, and you have been in Korea for 5 years, you can apply for the F5 visa. But if you have the F27 visa, the period is reduced to 3 years. It is the case M. The family of a Korean or a permanent resident can also apply for a F5 visa. The family includes the spouse and the minor children. There is also different cases for investors. If you invested at least $500,000 and you have more than 5 Korean employees, you have no any minimum for the period of your stay in Korea. If you are an investor and you don't meet those conditions, there is also the case N and O, P, and Q. After are also eligible overseas Korean. high-skilled foreigners, those who have done a special contribution to Korea, and also retired workers. After, there are also two additional conditions. First, your financial capacity. Generally, you will need for one person an annual income above the gross national income per capita, which is around 37 million these days. And it will be less by person if you are three persons, for example. Secondly, you have, in principle, to prove that you have a sufficient command of Korean language and a sufficient knowledge of Korean society and culture. There are specific tests for that. But you may have an exemption for both, for example, for investors, or special talent, or special contribution. And sometimes there is an exemption for Korean culture and language only. For example, if you obtain your PhD in Korea, or even if you obtain your PhD abroad and you have been hired by a Korean company. Then this visa is interesting for at least three reasons. There is no limitation in your business activities, no limitation of period, even if the card has to be renewed every 10 years, and you can vote for local elections since 2005. It is important to add also that those benefits are for you and you, for your spouse if he or she can have a F5 visa too. We'll see now some business visa. D7 visa is designed for dispatched workers. It can be a worker sent from a foreign company to a local office in Korea, or a worker of a Korean company who will work in an office abroad. In the first case, you should have been in the company at least 1 year. The worker should be an executive, or a senior manager, or a specialist. But this condition of 1 year disappears in some cases. For example, if the company has invested more than $500,000 in the Korean office, the period of stay is up to 2 years. After the D8 visa includes, in fact, four types of visa. First, it is dedicated to indispensable skilled workers of a foreign invested company. In this case, you should have invested 100 million won and acquired 10% of the total stock. It is also for those who have established a venture based on advanced technology and who bring intellectual property rights. The third case is when you invest at least 100 million won into a company run by a Korean citizen, and it should be at least 10% of the total initial capital. The last case is for founders of a tech company, a startup. You need, in this case, a bachelor degree and intellectual property right or equivalent skills. So the purpose of the D9 visa is international trade. You are eligible in four cases. If you have a code number for international trade from Kita, if you are dispatched to an industrial equipment company, if you have been dispatched for supervision of shipbuilding or industrial equipment building, or if you have established and management this kind of company. Then the period of stay is up to 2 years. After, the E7 visa is the most common working visa in Korea. It is designed for people invited by a public or private organization and engaged in an activity specially designated by the Ministry of Justice. It is a little bit difficult to introduce this visa as there are 85 types of occupation and the same number of cases. For this visa, employers are usually subjected to a quota of 20% for sponsored foreign employees, but this limitation do not apply during a two-year period in some sectors as digital, manufacturing, trading, consulting, and R&D. the period of the stay of this visa is up to 3 years. I will finish with a word on the D10 visa, which allow you to seek a job during 6 months or give you the time to establish your startup in Korea. The D10-1 visa is a point-based visa. In this case, you need to look for a job in one of the activities provided by one of the visa between E1 and E7. Then I propose you to finish to see some useful information for foreigners in Korea. First, I remind you that you need a reentry permit prior your departure from Korea to be allowed to come back, except if you have an A-type visa or F4 or F24. You can apply for it in advance as the period of validity is 1 year, except if the remaining period of your visa or your passport is shorter. Since a few weeks, we were requesting an engagement from the administration on that point in order that French people in Korea can prepare their summer holidays. And it was published a few days ago on the iKorea website. We also asked several times more precision about the criteria they apply to accept or reject a reentry permit. On this point, they said us that it is now broadly accepted, but they will not produce any written communication. Of course, we think it's a problem in particular because we can hear that the criteria can be reinforced. Then all we can do now is to encourage you to get your permit in advance as it is valid for 1 year. After the exemption to the mandatory quarantine is still possible, but limited to executive for countries in the list of high sanitary risk countries. There are now 120 countries on this list. Under the current process, application should be submitted to the Business Travel Support Center operated by KITA. And also about the quarantine period, the government is preparing a project to reduce it, in particular for vaccinated people. And of course, we'll inform you when this change will be enforced. About the vaccination campaign, KDCA said us that foreigners who are in Korea as a resident with a long-term visa will be vaccinated in the same order of priorities as Korean nationals. It has begun last Monday with foreigners aged 75 years old or more. It will continue with people aged 75 years or more in May. And for people aged 50 years old, it seems that they will have to wait until July. We don't know exactly the agenda, as KDCI wants to finish the campaign for those who are eligible before to begin after the following category. There was also a question if we need to be affiliated to the National Health Insurance Service. KDCA has finally decided to extend vaccination to foreigners non-affiliated to the Korean Health Insurance. I also remind you that if you have an imperative business reason, you can be vaccinated through a special procedure for Koreans and for foreigners. You just have to be in Korea for at least 3 months if you are foreigner. I will finish on that and let you bring your information or your experience, or let you raise your question if you have.
My question is related to the current situation with COVID. So, as you said, it's been a fluid situation, and following the March 3rd, and our experience has been that there's been a lot of contradicting information from the different players First of all, from the Korean embassy. So in our case, is working with a small and medium enterprise where it's kind of unclear what is required to get the visas. You know, the embassy required some letter from the ministry, and then the ministry says that visas are not possible for French citizens above for more than 7 days, which we didn't see much of. And so you said that now there's some, you know, new guidelines saying that it will be possible in some cases. So just trying to get a sense of how aligned the different services are and the possibilities there. Thank you.
Yes, there was a lot of change since the beginning of March. First, the delegation of the visa issuance service to KVAC, and after the suspension of the visa. Then the situation in March, it was all visa was suspended at the beginning of March. And we did with our partner, with the French embassy and with the organization, a lot of discussion exchange with the Korean part in order to change that. And the exception was extended last week with, again, a different procedure. And for most of those visas, for KVAC, it will be the first time they will issue those visas. Then sometimes it's right, they are not clear how we can do. And we spent a lot of time at the FKCCI2 last week because it was the first week in this we can have those exceptions, and the process was not clear. Then since 1-2 months, the process changed a lot. It's in a point of our point of view, it's a good thing because it was blocked and now we see we can have exception. But at the beginning, the process was not clear. It's right. And it is a point we're working on these days. Then now it's more clear. And maybe for a case, we can see more in details after.
Okay. No, but thank you for all the work. I guess it's difficult.
Yes. Do you have any other question? I had some question about which visa is mandatory to open a business in South Korea. Then there are a lot of visa. There is no only one visa for that. Of course, we think about the D8 for investor. It's the main visa, but also all other visa of resident can allow you to open a business. But according the visa type, you can have a limitation on the sector. Then it depends. For example, F5 visa, you have no any limitation. For F2 visa, it depends of your previous visa before the F2. And it is your previous visa which can limit your activity. After, if you have a F4 visa, usually you can open your business too. But even if there is some condition, specific condition, but the most representative visa for opening a business is D8. Do you have any other question?
I would have another question on the F27 visa.
Yes.
Is there a base for, so is it a visa that can be applied outside of Korea, or is it, do you need to be already on a long-term visa to apply for F27?
In most cases, you need to be in Korea because you have a minimum period of stay in Korea. But in some cases, in particular, according your investment and the number of employees you have, you have not this constraint, then in some cases, it can be delivered even if you are abroad.
Okay, thank you.
And it's kind of the difficulty of the subject of visa is, you know, there is a lot of different cases. Even for each visa, there is a subcategory and a lot of exemption and principle. And it is sometimes one why we can be confused. And it's important before to go to the immigration to see in which case we are and what are the conditions. And the main source for that, it's the law on the Immigration Act and all the decree and the text, legal text related to this act, to know exactly what you can have. And we often see a situation where we have to check first and to say, according to the text, we have the right to apply for this visa or this visa in this condition. And administration will see if we check that, but it's usually easier way to have a visa, even in particular if it's not a common visa. And there are a lot of specific situations. How can we help on visa matters? We can try to understand with you your situation, in which case you are, and what you need. Then our main what we bring to you is our understanding of the visa scheme, to know in which case you are, which condition you need, and after we are in relation with all public institutions we saw on the COAN part, which are involved in the visa issuance process. Hello, thank you for the presentation. I was wondering if the D10 visa works, if we want to create a company in Korea, do we have only 6 months to create, or it will be profitable? Do we need to have investors? Yes, D10 visa is for, there is two types of visa, one for job seekers and another one for startup founder. In fact, startup funder, it's just for the preparation of your startup, and there is a specific program in order that you can prepare. But it's not the investor visa. You don't establish your startup with a D10 visa. Then you don't need any investor prior to receive the D10 visa. But there are some conditions of, in particular, you have to be in the process of startup preparation in order that Korean authorities can see that it's a very serious project. We are a French-Danish family, and we have a Korean agent working on our visa request, which is taking a while now. As per your experience, how long the visa process can take? Usually, the visa process is longer than usual. There are many changes these days, it's longer. Than usually, and it depends on the visa, in fact. It's difficult to give you a delay, but for one visa, we can take 3 weeks before. Now, it can take two months. Hello, you said that E7 visa was for a maximum of 3 years. Does that mean we can renew the E7 visa after 3 years? Or that we have to look for another type of visa after 3 years. We have to renew it, but the condition will be the same, and the immigration will check after 3 years if you meet with all the conditions for the E7 visa. Then there is no engagement after 3 years. But it can be renewed. I would like to know how Korean authorities count the period of sojourn in Korea. For instance, if you are students with a visa D2, If you leave Korea, the period will be back to stay to zero or stay. For F2 or F5 visa, yes, you have a minimum period of stay in Korea. And I don't remember exactly how we calculate that. There is formula, but I think, of course, you can go and come back. You can go abroad during this period, but I don't remember exactly the condition. Regarding the E7 visa, if a company based in Korea doesn't meet the requirement to sponsor the visa, which option is left for the employer and employee? There is all the visa the employee can get individually. We saw the F2, F5, and other visa. After, there is no lot of other solution if you don't meet the requirement. But sometimes we can find a solution. It depends on each case. And for this each specific case, you can contact us to in order that we can see if there is an exception for you. As I said today, there is a lot of principle of exception and exception for exception. Then for each case, we have to look for a solution. And it's the main difficulty in this matter. Then if you have no any more questions, I propose you to finish. I really thank you to participate to this discussion. Thank you very much.